News just in, actor Preeti Zinta has issued a statement after news of a police complaint against her former boyfriend and industrialist Ness Wadia came to light. She says, and I quote from her statement now, "This is a very difficult time for me and I would like to request the media to please respect my privacy regarding this matter. My intention is not to harm anyone but only to protect myself," unquote. Alright, a statement from Preeti Zinta coming out. Finally, she's saying that her intention is not to harm anyone but only to protect herself. We have a confirmation that the police has registered a case against her former boyfriend and industrialist Ness Wadia. Preeti Zinta, remember, has alleged that he molested her during an IPL match on the 30th of May. A police case has been registered. Preeti Zinta claims the incident took place in front of several people who were present there watching the match. In fact, the police is also likely to ask Ness Wadia to join them for questioning today. Let's get an word from our Mumbai Bureau Chief Sahil Joshi, who's joining us on the phone line from Mumbai. Sahil, what's the latest in terms of investigations? Have the police been able to identify eyewitnesses? Are we expecting the police to question Ness Wadia today?
See, it is unlikely that they will question Mr. Wadia today itself, because what police had said that they had converted the complaint into FIR yesterday. After that, they will be identifying the witnesses who were present in the VIP area during that particular match on 30th of May. After that, they will be speaking to them. After that, they will be also examining the CCTV footage if they find anything in that CCTV footage. Accordingly, then they will call Ness Wadia for questioning. Now, we have spoken to some close sources of Ness Wadia, and what they are telling us is that Ness Wadia is going to appoint a proper legal counsel in this particular matter, because he understands the legal implications of this particular case. Secondly, they are raising questions on Preeti Zinta's complaint by saying that during that particular match in the VIP enclosure in Wankhede Stadium, Ness Wadia's parents, Nasli Wadia and his wife, was also present at that particular time. They also told us that Ness Wadia has a girlfriend at this point of time after breakup with Preeti Zinta. And she was also present in the VIP area at the time when Preeti Zinta is claiming that such and such incidents has happened. So what they are saying is basically when Ness Wadia's parents and Ness Wadia's current girlfriend were there at that point of time, how can such kind of incidents have happened? But they are saying that as the complaint has been filed, they will be going for a proper legal action and they will be appointing a legal counsel. And whenever the police calls, as per the way their legal support tells them to do and suggests them to do things, they will do it and they will fully cooperate with the police in this particular matter.
Sahil, stay on with us. Our Mumbai Bureau Chief confirming that Ness Wadia is likely to seek legal recourse. He's likely to appoint a legal counsel for the case. Both were in a VIP area where many VIP guests were present. Ness Wadia's parents, Nusti Wadia, and his wife were also in the same enclosure. Sahil Joshi is getting us the latest on this story. Sahil, you're saying that there were many VIP areas inside that enclosure where this incident reportedly took place. Is there anyone that the police has been able to identify who will back Preeti Zinta's side of the story?
See, the thing is that police will have to speak to the administrators, organizers at this point of time to get the details of the people who were present in the VIP enclosure during this particular match. After that, they will be speaking to the people that whether, as mentioned by Preeti Zinta, such incidents has happened or not. If they get any inclination of that sort of incidents, then accordingly they might call Preeti Zinta's bodyguards as well, because it is told that Preeti Zinta carries bodyguards also with her. So it is expected that those bodyguards were also present during this particular incident. So they might be speaking to those bodyguards. They will be speaking to the organizers of that particular match, any other people who were present in that particular VIP enclosure, because every team has been given a particular space in Wankhede Stadium during IPL matches. And normally the list is with the organizers that so and so people have been told to come there. Just to give you an update, Simi, we have got details of Preeti Zinta's treatment which she has given to the Marine Drive police station, and she has written this statement in English. And if you can give me some time, I can read out the statement to you, Simi.
Yes, please.
What she has said, I mean, the statement which she has given to the police, senior police inspector of Marine Drive Police Station, and the statement was given on 12th of June 2014, that is the day before yesterday, and what she has mentioned is that she knows Neswadia since 10 years and they had a relationship together for some time, and they have ended their relationship, although they are co-owners of the team Kings 11 Punjab. But they are no longer in the relationship and only talk for professional reasons and work. That's what she has clarified. She has also said that for some time now, they are not even talking to each other. In between once or twice, they had some heated argument regarding work, that is regarding Kings 11 Punjab. And during that time, she has said that he tried to abuse her. I mean, she has said that it has happened even before. Let me reiterate the statement what she has said again, that she has said that they had stopped talking to each other after their breakup. After that, once or twice they had a heated argument regarding their work, and during that time Neswadia tried to abuse her and used extremely derogatory language and tried to behave in a manner where she was put to shame in front of her colleagues, friends and family. That means she is saying that whenever he did that, he did that in front of other people as well, when her friends and colleagues were also present. According to Preeti Zinta, what she has mentioned in the statement is that she has orally warned him during that time and told him that she is not comfortable with such kind of behavior. But despite that, she says that these kind of things did not stop. In other paragraph, what she's saying in the statement is that in spite of her complaint, he persisted with his behavior, and finally, she had written a personal mail and warned him. She is saying that she had written a personal mail and warned him not to behave in a manner which will harm and degrade her character and put her in shame.
Right. Sahil, stay on with us. We're also being joined by Rekha Agarwal, women's rights activist on the phone line. Thanks so much for speaking to Headlines today, Ms. Agarwal. An extremely unfortunate story being reported from Mumbai. Your first reaction?
Absolutely shocked to hear that. I thought that it was the end of the relationship. But it seems that there are some bitter notes in the relationship still left, which has probably led to this current state of affairs. And I do respect a woman's privacy. And I don't think that any man, you know, he has got any right to encroach upon a woman's life and her privacy if she's not interested in him anymore. And it's from what I have been able to gather in the short time that this I've read about this in the media, I think that Mr. Wadia probably did something which has offended her modesty, and she has lodged a complaint under Section 354 IPC. And let law take its own course. As of now, the matter is very, very delicate, and respecting Ms. Zinta's privacy, I would not like to comment upon it further. And time will tell what exactly were the ingredients of her complaint and what action she would like to be taken against Mr. Wadia. I think that the matter should be left, at this stage, and not much should be commented upon it, lest it hurt her sensibilities and sensitivity and emotions even more, because as a lady, I can understand and have fully empathized with her. I can imagine the state of mind she must be in right now. It seems that she had warned him to stay away from her and not do any take any action, covert or overt, which would defame her or hurt her emotions. But it seems that that gray line which is there between every relationship between right and wrong has been crossed by Mr. Wadia. Very, very unfortunate state of affairs.
Right. Ms. Rekha Agarwal, there are some details about the police report that are now coming to light in which the actor has alleged that this wasn't the first time when she was harassed by Neswadia even after they had parted ways.
Yes, I think if after the criminal amendment which has been taken place after the Nirbhaya case, there have been very, very positive amendments that for first, there is something which is called a first-time offender, and there is another thing which is called a repeat offender. So if the actor feels that this is a repeat action and she will not take it anymore, Now I think we have reached the stage where not only the law but even our current Prime Minister speaks of zero tolerance where you know, indignities or illegal acts against women are concerned. And a woman has a right to say no, I'm not going to take it anymore. So if Mr. Wadia has done it yet once more, she has a right to protest. She has a right to register her complaint and let Lord decide what is going to be the fate of the complaint that she has registered, whether it has been registered, converted into an FIR or not, or whether the police are still conducting a preliminary investigation in the matter. I'm not aware of that, but the law definitely provides that the moment the woman lodges a complaint of a cognizable offence, the police has no choice but to register an FIR and conduct an investigation into the same.
Absolutely, Ms. Rekha Agarwal, thanks so much for speaking to Headlines today. The police has in fact registered an FIR and is likely to question Ness Wadia soon. We're also getting in a reaction from the National Commission for Women, which has demanded a fair probe into the matter. Let's listen in.
और उन्होंने कहा हुआ है FIR लॉज है, FIR की कॉपी मेरे हाथ में है, अगर गुना हुआ है तो गुनेगार को अरेस्ट करना ये पुलिस का काम है और वो उन्होंने करना चाहिए। FIR में जो है कि पब्लिक प्लेस पे उनके साथ जो गैर बर्ताव जो किया हुआ है वाड़िया ने, वो उसके बारे में उन्होंने कहा है और उसी के बारे में ये FIR बना हुआ है और इसके ऊपर पुलिस जो है जल्द से जल्द कार्रवाई करेगी। आने वाले 24 घंटे में आरोपी को गिरफ्तार करने के आदेश जो है पुलिस ने हमें दिए हुए हैं। जो भी इसके लिए कुछ सीसीटीवी फुटेज वहां पे जो बात हुई है, जैसे कि प्रीति जिंटा ने अपने स्टेटमेंट में कहा है कि ये बात जो है पब्लिक में हुई है, तो उनके लिए जो भी विटनेस है वो आ जाएंगे और सीसीटीवी के फुटेज जो है वो भी पुलिस को मिल जाएगी और उसके ऊपर से जो है उनके ऊपर आगे की कार्रवाई होगी।